Critics say the government is playing morality police and harming legitimate businesses in the guise of protecting consumers. And now the investigators of potential fraudsters are themselves being investigated. Correspondent Mike Tobin explains Operation Choke Point.
Mike Schutz owns the tiny Hawkins Gun Store in northern Wisconsin. He banked through his local credit union until last November.
I received a call from the local credit union, and they told me that I had to come in and close my business account.
Suspicious of the reason why, he went in and recorded the bank manager.
We don't do firearms, ammunition, imports, attorneys, auctioneers, and check cashing companies.
His business was placed on a high-risk list created by the Department of Justice program called Operation Choke Point. The same list includes escort services, get-rich products, and Ponzi schemes. As part of the operation, banks and payment processors are told if they keep accounts with businesses on the list, they will be subject to heightened scrutiny and increased audits. We located several business owners, from payday lenders to pawn shops, who say their accounts were closed because of Operation Choke Point. Congressman Sean Duffy says the operation was created to combat fraud, but evolved into morality police, with bureaucrats subjectively targeting businesses.
They figured that if they could cut off legal businesses' ability to bank, they could put those businesses that they don't like out of business.
The Department of Justice told Fox News, "We do not target businesses operating within the bounds of the law, and we have no interest in pursuing or discouraging lawful conduct."
That's a bold-faced lie. We have memos from the Department of Justice that show that they were actually targeting legal businesses.
One memo provided to us seems to show an indifference to harming legal business. Consumer Protection Branch Director Michael Bloom writes in reference to payday lenders, "Although we recognize the possibility that banks may have therefore decided to stop doing business with legitimate lenders, we do not believe that such decisions should alter our investigative plans." The U.S. Consumer Coalition says Choke Point has intimidated banks into closing thousands of accounts.
This is one of the greatest abuses of power that the country has never heard of.
Most of the businesses we contacted have been able to find alternative banks. Mike Schutz may be able to return to his local credit union. However, he found another bank to avoid going out of business in the meantime. Congressman Duffy thinks those alternative bank accounts will only last until federal investigators scrutinize those institutions as well. And Duffy wants to make Operation Choke Point the subject of congressional hearings, possibly next month. Brett,
Mike Tobin in Chicago. Mike, thank you.